Good evening. Where is it that you're currently off to again, James?
Finland, like it says in the description. I'm going to Italy.
Oh, okay.
I've just done the video. It's bolting to Finland. I thought I had a load to Finland. I haven't. I'm going to Italy.
But first driver's mistake.
Yeah. It's only what? 150,000
miles along there. Yeah, you could say that your delivery would be slightly late.
Where are you? In Finland, Helsinki.
I'm just currently myself going through Hirtshals in
Denmark.
What have I got again? I can't even remember what I've got. Oh, that's it. I've got used packaging. 20 tons of it.
Malish combi.
Nice. Yeah, good old Fiesel. I've got the tag up as well, James, believe it or not.
Okay.
20 ton bollocks trailer. Like, the faster you go, or the sharper you turn, it sorts to like, you know, that's when it likes to jiggle about a little bit. If you drive her nice and steady, she goes right. I really can't see to how you get issues with the truck and trailer slowing your game down. True. Yeah, that would be good. Oh, that was the thing. You know when we said earlier on I had that first expedition of this feature? From it wasn't going from Hirtshals originally. It was going from Aalborg.
Okay.
So I took it from Aalborg to Bergen, and you know when you said about you should just go the other way and go up round through private rather than, you know, one boat journey.
Yeah.
That's what I'd done earlier on.
Okay.
I ended up doing that as a round trip. I've got quite a few extra experience points as well, I think, for it as well.
Okay. You don't need the experience points now, do you? You've got bloody loads.
I'm not too bad. I've managed to drop me money down from 15 million to 9 million.
No, this is a very realistic guy, but I'm not seeing any traffic now.
Just hoping to get where I'm going to now, and then fingers crossed, if all works out, I've adjusted where the Fiesel Trans trailer sits in the mod file. That hopefully now I will get a few more of those rather than just the Stees. I seem to be getting quite a few Stees and less of the other fridge trailers. So I've left the Stees where it is, which is sort of like halfway up the mod file. And then the Fiesel I've put above the Stees, but a little bit further up as well, so it's got a bit more higher priority.
Okay.
Because I've noticed that, the higher priority that you have your trailers in sequence is how often that you'll get them in game. Oh, this poor little 540 just struggled up that hill then. It's just got its standard engine as a standalone.
Yeah.
Well, that's not very good.
Oh,
I don't mind it. I'm not. You know, with this Volvo, I was surprised that it had a sound with it as well. And it doesn't sound half too bad either. Huh? Well, that's what's. Parker's Volvo sounds like, doesn't it? That sounds like a DAF. Oh yes, great. Last place that I haven't been into. Wee, slow down a bit, Jeff. Proper in there. Going over there. Oh, hello. Piso Trans and Ronnie Cusers, what do you think? Huh? But that's with the Volvo, not the Scania. Bit amazed myself to how I've managed to get them two Charoo trailers to work, the Griffin and that one with the red wheels.
Yeah, I'd like to know.
I can't work it out. I don't even think I should try and work it out because I'm probably not going to get anywhere. A bit further south. You're having a few little problems there.
No problems. It's just very busy.
Huh. Yeah, I had that earlier on, going over a bridge, coming to join a slip road. It was going from two lanes to one as you go around the bend. And going over the bridge, the car just decided that it wanted to go from like 50 down to about 25 in a matter of like 30 yards. And it was like, I'm not stopping, mate. I had retarder full on brakes in like third gear. Dropped it straight from 12th down. Well, no, I don't think I was in 12th, I was in like 10th or 9th. So I dropped it straight from 9th down to 3rd or 4th. Get the revs and to try and get the engine to slow me down. Foot slammed on the brakes, started fully on, and I still didn't stop. Funny.
That's why it seems to me everybody was broken up. They were going into both roads. Going to the other side of the road.
Okay. Say that as well.
Like just a
Yeah, a bit like that guy that parked on that level crossing.
Oh my.
With that red cab Scania, he sort of saw the lights going, drove on there, saw the barriers come down, and decided he wanted to stop rather than try and go on and, you know, maybe just bend the barriers or something. But he just stopped there, and then before you knew it, 20 seconds later, this like express train just comes out of nowhere, rips his trailer straight from him and his cab, well, and his chassis, his truck, the lot, and literally the train goes past and you just see the cab sat there in the middle, and you think, holy moly, what did that guy just go through? What must he have been thinking when that train hit that bleeding truck and it spun him round and literally just ripped the cab clean off the hinges?
Thank God I'm not going on Renault Magnum.
No, but it was the fact that it was so precise on how the train hit the truck and that cab landed, like, perfectly sat upright in the road. The guy just got out of it. I would hate to imagine what it would have been like if maybe he wasn't wearing a seatbelt. Christ, I'll tell you that would definitely have catapulted him out of that.
Yeah.
No two ways about it. Ha ha ha! That might be a bit painful.
Oh, just a bit. Certainly wouldn't be super, would it?
No, not really. Oh, and that's another thing, James. Also.
What's that?
The 143.
Yeah.
Remember the Patrick Van Leniova that I had?
Yeah.
I also have that as well with matching lightbox.
Okay.
Or the 143.
I don't know what to think of that 143. It needs a lot of work.
I suppose it does, but it's okay for the minute.
It's just everything else like came out of like 1.14 version of ETS2, same as that 143. And everything else has been updated and that's just had like nothing done to it. Nobody's even made possible.
Of course. there's just a changing gear, isn't it?
Also having to contend with two plate here, guys, so bear with me. Anybody own a V8 in real life that comes to it, whereas I live next to the busiest stop in the country, I'll happily let you pull my tree out of your V8.
That's true, because the first time it wasn't really planned, was it?
Oh yeah, happy Valentine's Day, folks. All them love ones out there.
left of it.
I stopped. Sorry guys, I didn't see that train line there and I was going too fast to stop.
What's that?
The nuclear power stations on Wheel of France.
Oh, yeah. Been to two of them already.
Have you?
Yeah.
I seem to keep driving past the same one.
Hey?
I seem to keep driving past the same one.
Holy moly, that's close. I have.
Yeah.
Yep, three.
Sorry about that, guys. How I didn't see a 6-foot bump in the road, I don't know. Yeah, we'll do the rest of this tomorrow, I think. We'll get to the Italian border tomorrow, and then tomorrow evening we should be hopefully at Valencia. Venezia?
Alright.
Please remember to hit that subscribe button, and if you like what you see, click the like button. Also, look forward to hearing from you in the comments section below.